Hello friends, this is Pradeep Reddy and today I want to give a demonstration lecture, and in this session we will be deriving equation for electric field due to a rod. Right, as we know, between two charges, like charge is the fundamental property of any particle. There are two types of charges. One is positive and the other one is negative. If this is positive charge and there should be a negative charge, and if these two charges are separated by certain distance, say r, and if this charge has value q1 and this charge has value q2, then force acting between these two charges is given by Coulomb's inverse square law. The magnitude of the force acting between two charges is given by equation F magnitude is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r square, where q1 q2 are the magnitudes of the charges and r is the separation between two charges, right? And if there is a point charge, for example, let me take a point charge plus q, let me take this as capital Q, and from this point charge let us take a point P which is at a distance r from the point charge plus q. At this point, if I want to calculate field by the basic definition of electric field, you can write it as F divided by capital Q. Force acting at this point P by this charge capital Q gives you electric field E. Of course, I'm not going to tell details of electric field and electric force as this is demo lecture. So directly I am going to the derivation of electric field due to rod. But before that, you need to have brief introduction regarding these equations. That is the reason why I am explaining these values of F and E. So electric field is given by equation E is equal to F by capital Q. Now you can substitute F over here, then it gives you 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught . Let me take here a small point charge small q, then you can write it as capital Q into small q divided by, I'm sorry, this is small q. So capital Q small q divided by r square into q. This q and this q gets cancelled. So electric field E can be given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q divided by r square. This is the basic equation we have to calculate electric field due to any point charged object. This is equation for electric field. Now, as a part of demo, we will be learning how to derive equation for electric field due to a rod. Electric field due to a uniformly charged rod. Now let us take one rod. this is a rod of length capital L. And let us consider the charge on this rod is capital Q, right? So capital Q is equal to charge on a rod. L is equal to length of rod. Now I want to find out field at this point, say at this point P. I want to calculate electric field produced by this charged rod of charge capital Q, and this separation, I can take it as x dash. Let me consider that separation as x dash. Now, in order to derive equation for field due to this rod, as it is extended body, rod is an extended body, you cannot directly use the relation E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q by R square. This equation is not directly applicable for this rod because it is extended body. Rod is an extended body. For point charges, you can find it directly by using the formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. This equation is valid for point charges only. But here rod is an extended body. You cannot find field due to this rod directly by using this formula. So we will be using technique of integration and differentiation, and we will be finding out electric field due to this rod, right? So before that, let me tell you one small concept. Like, if this total rod has charge capital Q, then we can find out this is uniform distributed charge. Throughout the rod is capital Q. So you can define linear charge density for this rod as linear charge density, which will be defined by lambda, which is denoted with lambda. It is total charge, equipped on the body, divided by total length of that particular body. It is, as it is linear, we are dealing with length only. So you can write now lambda is equal to capital Q divided by capital L. So that gives you charge per unit length. Charge per unit length, or you can even define it as linear charge density, lambda, which is Q divided by L. Now, my intention is to derive equation for electric field due to this complete rod. So therefore, I'll take this rod, and as this equation is not applicable for whole rod, I'll divide this rod into very small pieces like this. Say this is one part, this is another part, this is another part, this is another part. Like that, I will divide this total rod into as many parts as possible, out of which one part I'm taking it here. Now this part has length small l, and dl. This very small length of the whole rod, it is denoted with dl, infinitely small length dl. And this infinitely, as the whole rod capital L has charge capital Q, this dl length will have charge dq. Fine. So this dl length of the rod, infinitely small length of this rod, has charge dq. Just like how we have defined charge, linear charge density for the whole rod, we can define linear charge density for very small element as well. So I'll continue my derivation here. Linear charge density of small element lambda. Charge density is always, linear charge density is always denoted with lambda. So linear charge density of the small element lambda can be written as dq, because the small element has charge dq and length dl, right? Now this dq by dl is equal to lambda, but however we have got lambda is equal to q divided by l. I will equate this with capital Q divided by capital L. Therefore, charge dq is equal to capital Q divided by L into dl. Take this as equation number one, right? So now we have charge dq, this total charge dq, its value has been obtained. The value of this dq charge has been obtained. Now, because of this small element, we will first find out the field. This element is separated by some distance, say x. The small element dq is being separated from the point P at a distance x. So first, I will now find out, let me draw that figure once again here. So we have small element, right? This is very small element. This small element has charge dq and its length is dl. And the total distance from here to here, we have denoted it with x. And here is point P. Now I want to find out, as this is very small element, so you can take this as point object. So for point object, you can find out electric field easily by using the basic equation, electric field equation. Because of this small element, you will have electric field DE, which is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Charge is dq divided by separation of that charge, it is x square. So dE is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught dq by x square. This is written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. dq is already obtained from equation 1. You can write it as q by l into dl divided by x square. Right. So for our simplicity, I'll now just change the variables. Here we are denoting it with this very small length. I will change this length as x so that it becomes very easy in deriving that this part. This I will denote it with dx. That's not big issue here. This I will denote it with dx. So in this derivation, we can replace this dl. This dl, I can replace it with dx. Right? So then this will be dx. Dx divided by x square. Now this is because of very small element. Now let me take this as equation number 2. Right? Now for the whole rod, this is the whole rod. Here I want to find out E. But what did we do now? We have calculated field due to this very small element which is having charge Q. But what I need to do, I want to find out total field from here to here. Total field produced because of the whole rod of length L. Therefore, we will now find out, like as I already told you, there will be very small elements. Each element will have field produced at this position. What we will do, one element is here, let its charge be dq. Another element can be here, let its charge be dq. Like that, all elements charge you will be adding over, which gives you integration of the whole charges, integration of the whole fields even. Therefore, in order to find out the net field, I will write it as E is equal to integration dE, which is sum of all electric fields produced due to the small elements which has been derived, which has been divided within that particular rod. And this is equal to integration 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q divided by L dx divided by x square. Now when we are integrating, we are finding field over here. We need to use limits of this rod. This rod has particular limit. Its length is L. Therefore, if I am taking very small element over here, this part, its length is denoted with x dash. So because of this very small element, there will be field over here and it is at a length of x dash. So I will take the limit x dash, and here we have this total charge, small charge dq. Because of this, the total length from here to here, it is written as L plus x dash, right? Now this gives you capital L plus x dash. The limits of the rod will be x dash to L plus x dash. And what is this x over here? X is length from very small element from here to here. Okay. Now evaluating this integration, as these terms are constants, I'll bring them out. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q divided by L integration x dash L plus x dash into dx divided by x square. Now as we know, integration of 1 by x square dx is equal to minus 1 by x. Integration of 1 by x square dx is equal to minus 1 by x. Or even you can write it like this. This is equal to x power minus 2. X power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. That gives you minus of 1 by x. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q divided by L. Integration dx by x square is minus 1 by x within the limits x dash divided by L plus x dash. This will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q divided by L. I'll now substitute the limits over here. negative sign I am taking common. This is 1 by L plus x dash minus of 1 by x dash. Right? So finally, we have got the expression for electric field due to a rod E, which is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q divided by L into 1 by x dash minus of 1 by L plus x dash. I'll just take this minus negative sign and multiply with this term. So as a result, 1 by x dash minus 1 by L plus x dash will be the final expression. Right, this is equation field due to a uniformly charged rod. Similarly, you can take any extended object and you can use the concept of integration and differentiation, and you can find out electric field due to that particular object. The electric field due to ring you can calculate, electric field due to disk you can calculate, like that. For any extended object, you can use the same procedure and you can find out electric field due to any extended object. Thank you. Have a good day.